Hey guys! Today I want to show you four 1940s inspired braided hairstyles. I recently came across a lot of photographs and videos of braided hairstyles from the 1930s to 1940s, and I thought they were so much fun. I went on a little research trip on Pinterest and I actually found so many photographs of old Hollywood stars just like Hedy Lamarr, Marilyn Monroe, Lana Turner, or Rita Hayworth, and actually many, many more, wearing braided hairstyles in the 1930s to 1940s, and I was super inspired by that, so I thought I would recreate four of them, and those would be perfect for a day where you don't have the time to set your hair the night before, or when you just want a practical but still authentic looking vintage hairstyle. So yeah, if you want to see how I create them, then just keep watching, and I hope you enjoy these as much as me. The first thing that I will be doing is, of course, brushing through my hair and get all the knots out. And I know that my ends are dry, so let's not talk about that. Next up, I am sectioning my hair into three sections. So we have two smaller sections in the front and then one bigger section in the back. And I'm clipping the smaller sections away because I will be concentrating on the biggest section at first and then get back to the smaller sections in the front. Now it's time to get that mirror out because I will be parting my back section into two sections because those will be the braids. And then I'm starting to braid my hair, and as you can see, I'm doing this at the very bottom of my head just because that is what it looked like to me on the photograph.
Here's some news that's dynamite. Baby named the day tonight. Stand by for the announcements. And more good news, back again, now it's done, the city hall, just name was one, stand by.
Once I'm done with that, I'm taking a bobby pin and I'm securing my braid, just because I don't have any small hair tie. And then I am also loosening my braid a bit, so that it looks a bit less tight. And then I am doing the same exact thing on the other side.
For the announcements and more good news.
Now on to my front sections. So I am taking one of them and I'm doing this kind of victory roll. So I am rolling my hair towards my head. And then it is basically just arranging the victory roll to look like you want it to look. I try to make them look a bit more like in the photograph, but of course you can do whatever you want with the front. And then I of course also did the other half, and when you're doing the second section, then you actually get more like a picture of how it could look together, and then you can do a lot more of arranging and maybe also rearrange your first section. It's basically really just all about arranging until you're happy with the result. Then I'm using a Bristol brush, I think is what they're called, just to make the sides a bit smoother and to get rid of the frizz, just to make it look a bit more put together. And then I am doing the final touches and again rearranging using a lot of bobby pins until I am happy with the result. And then, to spice it up a bit, I am using these hair ribbons. I think they just add something to the look. It looks definitely a bit more childish, so definitely not for everyone, but I personally really enjoy this look from time to time. To give it the final touch, I am curling my ends with my hands, which is only possible because of my hair structure. So if you have natural straight hair, then you can of course just use a curling iron and you're good to go. And that's the final look. I really like this one. I think it's so fun and fresh and also very practical for days where you just don't feel like curling your hair the night before. So for look number two, I am actually curling my hair the night before, and as you can see, I sectioned my hair into two sections in the back, which will be my braids, and the other sections I will be curling. And for that I am using some setting lotion, of course, and also some coconut oil. And I will be doing this section by section, starting with one of the side sections. I am just putting some setting lotion on it and taking a sponge roller, and I am rolling them up and under, as you can see, and then clipping them to secure them. And that's what I will be doing on both side sections. So rolling them under and then securing them. And now on to the front section. I am sectioning this one into three sections, clipping the other two sections away, and then I'm starting with the front section and also rolling it under. And that's what I was doing with the rest of my section. It's a new day! Yay! And I am again brushing through my hair and also parting my back section into two sections to start braiding them. And since I sectioned my back sections into bigger sections, the braids are turning out a bit thicker, which is what I wanted to achieve for this look, as the braids on the photograph of Lana Turner also looked a bit thicker. And then doing the same thing on the other side, of course. And now there's half the hairstyle already done, which is great. And now we will do the last step, and I am taking out all of my sponge rollers. Starting with the side sections, and I'm combing through them. And then I am again taking my bristle brush to get out all the frizz and to make it a bit more smooth. And then I am actually again doing a victory roll on the side, which will add a bit more of volume, which we want to achieve for this look. So for the poodle, we need all these little curls in the front, so I'm taking out the front section. Now I look like this. And I am also combing through them just to get them a bit more into a nice shape. And as you can see, I want this little arch on the side, which I saw in the photograph. I'm just trying to figure out how to do this poodle and just playing around a bit and securing the curls with bobby pins. And yeah, it's again all about arranging. I am just trying out different things until it actually works out for me. So that's how it ended up looking, and to finish up the look, I am again taking out my sponge rollers, taking care of the side section with just combing through it and then doing a victory roll. And the last victory roll can be very important because You can actually shape it the way that it makes the other hair looks better, if that makes sense. I, for example, decided to make the last one a bit more voluminous than the other one, just to balance it out a bit, since there was so much going on the other side, and yeah. And I am again adding some hair ribbons, but you can of course also add something else or just leave it plain. The second look is completed, and I have to say that this is probably one of my favorites of the bunch I'm showing you today. I think I just really like the mix of curls and braids. I think it just complements each other very well.
This year's crop of kisses don't seem as sweet to me.
Moving on to the third look that I want to show you today, and as you can see, I sectioned my hair into two sections with a middle part. And since I want to do standing milkmaid braids, I am braiding my hair on the top of my head. But if you want to see how to do normal milkmaid braids, then make sure to check out my tutorial for that. I will be linking that up there and also in the description box. Again, I am doing the same thing on the other side. And then I am trying out what would look best and which of the braids will go in the front and which one will go in the back. It always depends on which braid turned out better, so make sure to just try out what looks better in your opinion. I, for example, decided to put my right braid in front, so that's why I'm pinning down my left braid before. And after pinning both of my braids in place, I am taking a bobby pin or a few bobby pins, and I am actually trying to get rid of all these nasty hair that is sticking out because I want it to look a bit more clean and put together. And that's all for the third look. It's a very simple look, nothing too crazy, but very classic at the same time, and it actually goes with every look in my opinion.
Dreams I know can never be true. Seems as though I'll ever be blue.
So on to the final look, which also happens to be my favorite of them all. As you can see, I did a middle part again, and I am using two hair rats for this hairstyle that I clipped together to make it longer. In the front, I am combing back the two sections next to the middle part. This will be very helpful because then your hair stays in place and you can remove the clips after you put the hair rat in your hair. Now I'm taking the hair rat and I am doing this kind of Gibson roll in the back. You can see I am just rolling my hair around the hair rat and creating this kind of U shape.
You were lovely, I was lonely, on a night so long ago and far away.
And then I am pinning that down with a bobby pin so that the hair rat stays in place.
I could think of nothing sweet enough to say, so I kissed you
ho, I know the moon was not to blame. I know because I feel the same today. You will always be as lovely as you were so.
Once I'm finished with that, I am actually removing the hair clips and then I am taking a bobby pin just to secure the sides so that it looks a bit better. And once again, I am taking my little mirror just to make sure that the back looks nice. That is something that you should actually always make sure of when it comes to vintage hairstyles. So for the next step, I am actually taking this fake braid that I got off Amazon. You can also probably find a fake braid in your hair color. And I am opening this one and placing it on my head and then closing again, which can be a bit tricky, but you can do it. So once you place it on your head, that is how it looks like, and I think it looks so lovely. I just really like how effortless this one looks. But you have to make sure that you secure the braid, otherwise it can happen that it actually comes off your head. So that's what I would advise you. To give it the final touch and also make it look more like on the photograph of Hedy Lamarr, I chose one of those flowers. I think it adds such a summery, fresh look to it. And it can also match your outfit, which just makes it even better. And that's the final look, you guys. I hope you like this look. I actually really, really do. I think it's so elegant and so special and unique. So I'm very content with the way this turned out.
Daydreaming of wonderful you.
Thank you so, so much for watching, and I hope I will see you in my next video. Bye!